In this class, we can discuss economic load dispatch. In a power system, there will be number of power plants and each power plant will have several number of generating units. And total load on the system is varied from time to time. Economic dispatch problem determines the power output of each power plant and power output of each generating unit within a power plant. In each area or state, there will be some dispatch centers where the generation from each power plant is determined. Here we have load dispatch center at Kalamacheri. Economic load dispatch mainly consists of two problems: the unit commitment problem and online economic dispatch or cost minimization problem. Unit commitment problem is actually pre-dispatch problem. That is, we have some load data from the previous years. Depending on the data, the generation is scheduled. And online economic dispatch problem is done according to the current data. So, two problems associated with economic load dispatches: unit commitment or pre-dispatch problem and online economic dispatch. In unit commitment, the generators are selected optimally so as to meet the expected load, and it also provides some reserve capacity also. In online economic dispatch, the available load is distributed among the generating units which are connected in the system, and it is done so as to minimize the total cost of generation. Before finding the solution of these problems, we have to consider some system constraints or some limitations. We know that we cannot simply put some value of power for particular generator, because there is some limitations for active power, reactive power, voltage, some thermal limitations, temperature should not increase to a high value. So before assigning a particular value of power, some constraints has to be considered. That limitations are called system constraints. There are two types of constraints: equality constraints and inequality constraints. Equality constraints is mainly active and reactive power constraint depending on the load. Here, basic load flow equations are the equality constraint. Load requirement should be equal to power demand. Here, EP and FP are real and imaginary parts of the voltages, and GPQ and BPQ are conductance and susceptance of the bus, between the buses. And there will be inequality constraints, like the power should be within some limit, like less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, like that. There are two types of inequality constraint: hard type and soft type. In hard type, there will be specific values for the setting, like tap changing of on-load tap changing transformer. In soft type, there is some flexibility, like node voltages, phase angles between the node voltages, etc. We can discuss the system constraint in detail when we are discussing the unit commitment problem. Now we can move on to economic load dispatch problem. For finding the economic load dispatch problem, one of the important parameter is incremental fuel cost. For finding the incremental fuel cost, we are drawing incremental fuel cost curve. In figure 1, it shows a power fuel input versus power output curve. Input output curve. It is a parabolic curve. If we differentiate this, we will get incremental fuel curve. Incremental fuel rate is actually change in input by change in output. When we are differentiating the fuel input-output curve, we will get incremental fuel curve, which is almost linear. It is like a straight line. Next, we can move on to economic dispatch problem, neglecting losses. For finding the solution of a problem, we have to consider the constraints. Here, the main constraint is the generation should meet the load demand. Actually, the generation should meet the load demand and also the losses, transmission losses. Here, in economic dispatch problem, neglecting losses, here we are considering only load demand. This case is for mainly for generators within a plant. For different generators within a plant, we can consider the losses, transmission losses, as negligible. So load demand is equal to the generation. And the function to be minimized is cost function FT. That is sum of the cost of each generator, sigma n equal to 1 to n fn, where f1, f2, etc. fn are cost of each generators, subject to the condition that pd equal to sigma n equal to 1 to n pn. Pn is the power generation from nth generator. And for finding the solution for a minimization or maximization problem, we have seen in mathematics that there is Lagrangian solutions. Here in Lagrangian solution, the function is written in terms of Lagrangian multiplier by considering the constraints. Here the function is written as f equal to ft plus lambda into pd minus sigma n equal to 1 to n pn, where pd is load demand and pn is generation. When pd equal to pn, that term becomes 0 and f equal to ft, where lambda is called Lagrangian multiplier, it is a constant. So we know that a function is minimized or maximized when the differential is 0. So we can differentiate this function f with respect to generation pn. Dou f by dou pn equal to, when we are differentiating the function, dou ft by dou pn plus lambda into dou pd by dou pn is 0, as pd does not depend on pn, and dou pn by dou pn is 1. So dou f by dou pn equal to dou ft by dou pn minus lambda equal to 0. That is the condition for minimum cost. So dou ft by dou pn equal to lambda. Or we can say that dou f1 by dou p1 equal to dou f2 by dou p2 equal to etc. dou f1 by dou pn equal to lambda, where dou fn by dou pn is incremental production cost. So for optimum operation of the system, the incremental production cost of each plant should be equal. From the production cost curve, we have already drawn the incremental production cost curve. It is a linear curve. So from this curve, we can write the incremental function. If it is a linear curve, y equal to mx plus c is the function. So we can write dfn by dpn equal to fnn pn plus fn. Here fnn is the slope, fnn is the slope and fn is the intercept. So dou fn by dou pn equal to fnn pn plus fn, and also dou fn by dou pn is lambda. So we can write fnn pn plus fn equal to lambda, or the generation can be found out as lambda minus fn by fnn. So main condition for minimum cost is the incremental production cost of each machine should be equal. By using flowchart, we can understand the condition. So here we can find the power output, but we should the power output should be within the limit. It should not be more than the generation limit. So from starting we have to read FNN, FN, PD and E. The slope of the curve, intercept of the curve, load demand and small function E, which is for determining the change in load demand and the generation. That will be a small value. First, we can assume a suitable value of lambda and change in lambda. Usually, lambda should be greater than the intercept of incremental production cost curve. First, set n equal to 1 for first generator and so find the value of power. Power we have seen here, power equal to lambda minus Fn by Fn. By substituting the values, we can find the power and check if Pn is greater than the Pn max. If it is greater than the maximum limit of the generator, we have to set Pn equal to Pn max. If otherwise, check if Pn is less than Pn max. If it is less than Pn max, we can set Pn equal to Pn minimum. Otherwise, we can increment the count as n equal to n plus 1. Next generator can be considered. And if all the generator, all the buses has been accounted, then we can calculate change in power delta P. Delta P equal to sigma Pn minus Pd. Total generation minus load demand. If total generation minus load demand is less than small value E, we can print the generation cost or we can stop the problem. We have the solution. If sigma Pn is greater than Pd, it means that generation is more than the demand. Then we have to decrement the value of lambda as lambda minus delta lambda. If load demand is more than the generation, we have to increase the value of lambda as lambda plus delta lambda and continue all these procedures from n equal to 1 to n. Now we can see one problem. Here there are two generators of 100 megawatt each and their incremental production cost Kara is given as dou F1 by dou P1 equal to 2 plus 0.01 to P1, dou F2 by dou P2 equal to 1.5 plus 0.015 P2. And load on the system is 150 megawatt and minimum load on each unit is 10 megawatt. First, we have to assume some value of lambda. And lambda should be more than the intercept. That should be more than 2 and 1.5. So the maximum is 2. Lambda should be more than 2. So we can take a value of 2.8 and substitute that value of lambda to find the value of power using the equation P equal to lambda minus Fn by Fn. Here first curve Fn is 2 and Fnn is 0.012. Substitute that values and find values of P1 and P2. Here we got the answer as 66.6, 86.6 megawatts each. And total generation is 153.2 megawatt. We know that the load demand is 150 megawatt. So change in power, delta P, Pn minus delta Pg is 3.2 megawatt. There is an additional generation. So we can reduce the value of lambda. So we can reduce the value from 2.8 to 2.7. Substitute the value as 2.7 and again find the value of P1 and P2. 58.33 and 80 megawatt that can be added to get total generation as 138.33 megawatt. You can find the change in power demand and the power generation. So it is, we can find that generation is less than the demand. So the lambda should be greater than 2.7 and it should be near to 2.8. So we can directly take 2.77 like that or 2.75. So we can here we are considered 2.75. Corresponding to this generation, the P1 and P2 can be found out, and the total generation is 145.9 megawatt by substituting value of lambda as 2.75. So again, it is less than the load demand. So increase the value of lambda to 2.78, which gives approximately equal value as that of load demand. 65 plus 85.4, that is 150.4 megawatt. Also, we can substitute lambda equal to, it is little bit more than the load demand. So we can reduce the value to 2.77, and it will give actual optimal generation schedule. So by substituting different values of lambda, we can find the optimal generation schedule. Thank you. We can discuss some more problems in next classes, and also we can discuss economic load dispatch without by considering losses also. Please subscribe my channel to get all the videos. Thank you.